2015 saw the first three bell test experiments that claimed to contain no loopholes. Surely spooky action at a distance must really be happening. The use of the CH-SH inequality for a photon-based bell test is problematic because it requires 100% detection, which we cannot achieve with photons. But if we remove one detector at each side, then we can use the Eberhard inequality, which takes account of detection at one side only. But could the observed violations of this inequality be explained by classical physics? If 40 photons enter a polarizing filter, then the natural assumption is that only half of them pass through. But one possible way we could make use of Einstein's hidden variables would be to suggest that all photons might actually pass through, and then a hidden property would cause just half of them to be detected. Can a model using this approach produce the observed results? Yes, it can. Would it also predict the observed one-sided detections? Yes, it would. Whereas quantum mechanics does not predict any one-sided detections. The very first bell test experiments were also photon-based, and so you might well wonder why a classical physics explanation was dismissed. Well, the undetected photons were dismissed as not being important. They made the assumption that undetected photons had the same properties as the detected photons, which seems a bit strange. Surely it would be more reasonable to assume they had different properties, otherwise they should have been detected. It was claimed that the detected photons were a fair sample of all the photons. This gave them license to ignore the fact that the CH-SH inequality requires 100% detection. And so in order to explain why photons with exactly the same properties behave differently, we have to then assume that some mysterious, unspecified thing that is external to the photons is determining which ones get detected. Using this so-called fair sampling assumption, it was declared that experimental results confirmed the quantum mechanics predictions, and all counter-arguments were dismissed as being highly unlikely loopholes. John Clauser had a lot to do with the first ever bell test. He was one of the authors of the CH-SH inequality. And, working with Stuart Friedman, he performed the first bell test experiment in 1972. Later, he enjoyed discussing entanglement with the fundamental physics group, who wanted to use entanglement to promote Eastern mysticism. There was a very simple way to explain the results, which is this: if an entangled photon has a polarization angle close to an axis of the filter, then it has a higher probability of being detected. But if it was fair to assume that the undetected photons could be dismissed, then this was a sensational and highly newsworthy result that appeared to support the very weird idea that spooky action at a distance was real, and it would question the fundamental nature of reality. Arguably, the CH-SH inequality was inadequate for experiments like this, where a lot of photons are not detected. And it could be claimed that it was unfair to assume fair sampling. But the sensational news of spooky action was very appealing, and so entanglement soon gained general acceptance. This meant that only experimental results that appeared to confirm spooky action would get reported, possibly giving a completely false impression that quantum mechanics was highly successful. All counter-arguments were now dismissed as mere loopholes. If an experiment produces some exceptional result, then we might expect our scientists to change various aspects of the experiment to see how they alter the result, with the ultimate goal of trying to identify the cause of the strange result. If someone claimed to be able to read your mind, then hopefully we would not just believe them based on the result of a simple trick. But bizarrely, the scientific method of drilling down into the detail to find a cause was no longer required, because our scientists were believers in spooky action. Regardless of whether or not spooky action is really going on, there can be no excuse for not performing extensive and rigorous investigations to try to identify the cause. To simply accept these results as evidence of spooky action is not the action of a scientific investigator, it's the action of believers in mysticism. It's the action of people who want to believe that there are weird things out there that are beyond human comprehension. Instead, it's left up to the rest of us to try to guess at what the cause might be. This video is brought to you by extremefinitism.com.